him and Koopy as the main event next time.
Oh, okay, okay.
No, me and Robert.
You smile all the time. Yeah. You fucking, you look like a cool cat. Why is this motherfucker telling me that you're afraid of me?
Afraid of you?
Yeah, he told me that you're fucking afraid of me. That you're fucking. Yeah.
Don't say no. I've been shot at. So like that. Here's my video.
Right? You didn't tell me that?
Because you're mean, Robert.
What?
What the fuck?
What have I been
you're fucking mean. You're
look at this dude.
He's probably nah.
You're cold-blooded, dude.
I'm probably nicer than you.
Are you intoxicated right now?
He's been drinking.
Oh yeah, he is. He's above.
Do you have a designated driver? You need me to call an Uber? I'll call you a Lyft. I'll call you a Lyft. You okay? You shouldn't be driving.
You shouldn't be driving. Matter of fact, Ellie, the Lyft is SBPB.
Ellie was in Seattle.
I never met your mom.
Yes, you have. No, we met her. You don't remember? She told us that he's not Samoan in Vegas.
Yeah.
Oh,
Jaylian Love. Jaylian
Love. Your mom?
She said you were Samoan.
Because I'm just having an adopted mom or something.
Adopted mom.
Any fights tonight, security? All under control. Hey, you ever seen Friday After Next?
Yeah.
Top flight security in the world, Craig.
Top level security.
They're the all business. Okay, Benavidez a plan.
I don't know. It's a good fight. I give both of them it's a 50-50 fight, but you know, Caleb Plant, he boxes very well, but the problem is,
how are you guys doing?
If he can do that for the whole fight, because Benavidez brings the pressure.
He's a monster.
Yeah, he brings the pressure.
What do you think?
But who? I didn't hear.
Benavidez and Plant.
I'll go for Benavidez too.
Benavidez. He said 50-50.
Yeah.
He didn't pick a winner.
I said Benavidez.
Well, I'm probably 60-40. I lean more towards Benavidez, but Caleb Plant, he's a good
boxer. 64 is a big gap.
I know.
But okay.
Benavidez is going to destroy him.
He said the fight 50-50, but it's 60-40.
No, I said 60-40.
He said it's an even fight.
Almost, but I lean towards Benavidez.
I'm leaning Benavidez too, but it's not close. I mean, yeah. it's not an easy fight.
Yeah, it's not an easy fight.
But still, Benavidez can fuck him up.
Okay, what about Fulton and Inoue?
Inoue.
Pita, Fulton or Inoue?
Inoue.
Why?
TKO round 10. 9.
Fulton never lost.
Inoue neither.
Well, some of them all gotta go.
There's no L's in Inoue.
But why knockout?
Huh?
Why knockout?
Fulton is a bad dude, man. But I think Inoue is just like a generation.
But he's moving up the way?
Guy, like,
how about Tank and Inoue at 130?
Inoue would stop him. No, I'm just kidding. That's too much. That's too big.
Hey, Pacquiao did it.
Featherweight is the biggest he goes.
Pacquiao did it.
Featherweight is the biggest he goes. Yeah, but Pacquiao had a bigger frame too and a big ass head and steroids.
No, he didn't. No, Manny's the cleanest athlete ever. He could do.
Yeah, different type of fighter.
Okay, what about Estanionis and Virgil?
I think Virgil.
Before
last Pita, your prediction for Virgil Estanionis.
Oh, Virgil's gonna beat the shit out of him.
Yeah. What round do you think?
He's gonna stop him in like round 10 or 11. Probably.
Why so late?
Monday.
Why so late? Why so late in the fight?
Because Stanionis is not an easy dude. And he has a great jab. He's, you know, but I just think Virgil's just, you know, he's gonna break him down. It's gonna take some time. And once Virgil starts landing his jab, he starts landing that left hook to the body, he's gonna break him down. He's gonna stop him like in 10 or 11.
It's a lot of big fights coming up this year. I'm excited.
Oh, it's badass. It's badass.
The calendar's packed. They have so many fights on the same night. Jose Ramirez fighting the same night as Benavidez. Yeah. Adrian Broner's back.
Oh, yeah, he is. There's fighting. Five fights.
Do they have, is it good. Michelada or Zanagua?
Especially Sandia.
But that's good. So when are you fighting?
April 8th on Bam's undercard.
That's amazing. When are you fighting?
February 25th.
Where's that? Like Broner? You're on the Broner card?
Nah, it's going to be in TJ. Tijuana.
Okay.
Yeah.
It's good too. There's a lot of fights going on 25th.
Yep.
Mayweather's doing an exhibition in England. Jake Paul or Tommy Fury?
I want to say probably Jake.
Easy.
Yeah.
Easy work. Right? Jake Paul or Tommy? It doesn't matter to you.
Oh, I don't know.
I think Jake.
Yeah, I think something too.
But that's it. Good night of boxing here in San Bernardino. Packed house. A lot of people showed up. Kumbia, when are we seeing you and Frank the Cook go at it?
Never, man.
Why not? I've seen you spar. You got hands. I've seen you work out.
Nah, never, man.
I've seen Tank work out. I think you guys could have been.
I think you'll see us more sitting down at a table eating some food than fighting.
After the fight, I think you guys could have stepped in tonight as the main event. All right, really quick, introduce yourself.
My name is Jose Baby Bull Torres.
That's right.
And what's your record?
6-0, 1 draw, 5 knockouts.
All right, you fight at 135?
Yeah.
Tank or Ryan?
I got Ryan because he's my boy. Grew up with him.
Tank or Ryan?
Ryan.
Shit. Tank.
Tank. We got Tank.
Tank or Ryan?
Ryan, 100%.
Everybody. We got Tank. 100%. Tank,
100%. Ryan. We got Ryan. We got Ryan.
Why do you have Tank and everybody here have Ryan?
Because I think Tank's going to knock his ass out. He has a fucking...
Ryan's too big.
Why do you pick Ryan?
Because his height and his reach.
Pita, everyone here picked Ryan except him.
Nah, I got Tank. I got Tank.
That's right.
Who you got? Who you
There's
got?
Only one that's right.
That's right. Why do you think he picks Tank?
I don't know.
Why do you think they pick Tank?
Tank is going to be more effective. He has more boxing. You know, if he catches on what, he's going to knock him out.
You know the guy Jay Glazer from Fox Sports? The football guy?
No.
Why did they all pick Ryan? What do you think?
I think they picked Ryan because of the name, I think. You know, because he's a little bit more famous.
And Tank can fight. They both are famous.
I think it's gonna be a good fight.
Ryan has the background, right? Mm-hmm. He has the experience, which is good.
Which he could
come with Tank, right?
But Tank has
also has the fucking background.
The
thing is, yo, but you gotta look at, you gotta be real. Look, you guys are laughing. Check this out.
I'm not laughing. Yeah.
You got Ryan, and he's over here with his chin up all the time.
That's
and you
right.
See
and Ryan got
Dave,
it.
Ace fight every time. Has he corrected that? Now, Tank people is going to tell him, all right.
But you pick Ryan to win.
Who do you think?
No.
You pick Tank?
I pick Tank.
Tank, I gotta swear, I gotta run the tape Ryan, back because I heard him pick Ryan.
No, I would say Tank, man.
Come on. Everybody in the Empire, pull up K-Man Boxing.
For that's
K-Man
right, K-Man Boxing. Boxing.
Okay, last one I'm gonna ask you, baby bull. Yeah. Benavidez a plant.
Benavidez,
that's right.
Benavidez a plant. Decision or knockout?
Knockout.
What round?
Hey,
I think in a fifth round.
It's a great fight, I hope it happens. Five? What do you think?
What do you think about it?
It's a great fight, I hope it happens. Who wins?
Benavidez.
I got Caleb. Everybody got
Caleb.
Why?
Because he looks like Caleb Plant.
That's why. You got to look at the boxing skills. The defense that he carries. You got to look at that. The other guy got offense. He got a lot of... But you know what? Somebody that can fucking carry away all the defense and counter... It's going to be an interesting fight.
Listen to the
everybody
coach.
Just...
Okay.
What the fuck he's talking about? He knows his shit.
All right. Tell people where to follow you.
You can follow me on Instagram, JT.TheBull.
All right, and your gym, where you at?
KMF Productions.
Slowly. C-A-V-E? Cave?
Hold on.
KMF.
You should be wearing your shit, not New Balance.
Right here, baby.
Oh, there you go.
Right there. Right here, baby.
Hold on, we can't see shit.
Right here, KMF Boxing, dog.
KMF Boxing.
That's your business right now.
KMF Boxing, right here.
What does KMF stand for?
Keep on moving forward.
I thought it was like BMF. Reporting. Benavidez and Plant, give me your assessment.
You know what? After Plant's last fight, the way he performed and coming off of beating Canelo, I give him a better chance now. I think he has a, you know, before I used to say I would think David's just going to walk right through him, but... Him, the fact that he fought Canelo and he didn't do as bad as, you know, a lot of people expected. He actually did pretty good. He was able to box for a little bit. His confidence went through the roof because he saw what he could do with the best fighter with one of the best fighters in the world, arguably one of the best. And he, no matter who Canelo Plant's gonna fight, he's gonna be confident going into the fight. You know what I mean? I would still slightly favor David because of the size, the speed, and everything. But you cannot count out Caleb Plant. Now I give him a lot bigger chance than I did before.
Bivol or Bitterbaev?
I didn't see Bitterbaev because he fought today.
He didn't look good, but he got the stoppage.
I didn't get to see it.
He was down on two judges' scorecards.
Oh, shit.
He got hit, yeah. He's 38 years old.
No, he's older. Bivol's been looking really good, so I don't know.
Okay.
I don't know who I would favor.
What about Neno, 102 tune-ups?
Neno's a god.
Neno and Devin Haney, break it down.
Neno and what?
Devin Haney, if they fight.
Like Devin Haney is the undisputed lightweight champion of
right,
the world.
Right, that's why
he is the best lightweight in the world.
No,
right?
Tank's so the best. Tank is the best lightweight.
No, there's only Tank one champion at lightweight right now. There's only one champion at lightweight.
Tank Davis.
So Devin Haney. So we gotta be realistic. Neno hadn't fought in a long time, and you still saw how fucking hard he is. Look, they had a problem with the commission with the weight on the day of the event.
What happened? The opponent didn't get weight.
They made the fight at 143. Both guys weighed 143. The other guy came in lighter. He weighed like 139. Neno weighed right at 143. What California does now is they do a day weigh-in when you get to the locker room. the guy didn't gain any weight from yesterday to today, and Neno gained a lot of weight. So the difference was already a big difference.
Because
so
he's not a 140 pounder. So the guy
said we cannot sanction this fight. Yeah. So then they I was getting texts. I was doing the ticket, so I didn't know what the hell was going on. Then they told me that they were going to cancel the fight, this and that. But then they were able to convince them to do an exhibition. Headgear, the commission would take care of both fights. As soon as Neno dropped them, they stopped.
It's over. And Neno could have stopped him in the first 10 seconds
so
of the first round.
So as soon as the commission came, as soon as, you know, whatever, they stopped it right away. So, you know, that was that. So it was, you know. But besides that, it was a great turnout.
But Neno broke it. Oh, everyone had a great time.
Oh, it was good. The amateurs were good. The pros. Listen, you didn't get here to see the amateurs. The amateurs did really good, too. They were good fights. Yeah. It was good.
I've been on a lot of boxing fights in the last year. The crowd here, this was a sellout.
It was sick. We had to stop selling tickets. And we told people, you know what? We can't sell general admission tickets anymore. Like, we just can't. We can't. There's tables are sold out. Ringside sold out. We can't sell a single ticket anymore. And then, as people were leaving, the people were still waiting outside, and then they would come up, hey, those people just left. Can I buy another ticket? So we're like, all right, fuck it.
You're like the hottest.
So we doubled up on a lot of the tickets.
That's good. That's smart. That's you do. I said $1 million gate.
It was badass. It was badass, man.
That's cool. We done. Really good. But Mikey was here. I saw Jose Ramirez.
Jose Ramirez. Josito was here. Isaac Colunga was here.
Isaac Colunga
was here. Yeah, it was good, man. It was badass.
Everyone had a good time, and the fights were competitive. Chema's fight.
I didn't get to see any fights. I didn't get to see any of the fights.
I want
to
see him and Edgar Belenga. Can we make that happen?
He's got a fight. ¿Cuándo Belenga? El 4 de marzo. March 4th in Sinaloa, Culiacán.
Should I go with you to Sinaloa?
No, don't go. I'm not going. Nobody's going with him. ¿Vas a ir tú a su vela?
Why? Is it too dangerous?
No. Nobody's going over there. Fuck that. It's just dangerous as shit.
Hey, you spar Benavides.
Yeah.
How does he do a plan?
Benavides is going to win.
What round?
Maybe 7, 8.
Vita, he sparred. I was there when they sparred. They sparred in Andy Ruiz's gym.
I didn't see it.
I was there. Good sparring.
Was it? Who?
Him and Benavides.
And then can I say Andy Ruiz?
Yeah.
Can you see the sparring? Can I say nosotros también ahí con él?
No.
I saw him spar Espino, Caballo, and Falcao. And David is a bad motherfucker. That's why, even though Caleb Plant has the experience over there, I would still pick David. But it's not going to be easy. It's a close fight.
No, not easy.
No.
I went to visit him in Seattle yesterday.
How's he doing, camp? Badass?
They hate
each other. That makes the fight even better.
He's ready to fight tonight. Pita, he probably threw 1,000 punches in the rounds. Like, he throws flurries of 8 punches. Who does that?
It's pay-per-view, right?
That's good.
But you might be with Jose Ramirez.
I'm gonna be with Jose. No, I will be with Jose.
Look at that. Whose car is that?
Big G. That's Big G. Look at that.
Gangster.
Okay,
true story. You and Cumbia could have stepped in tonight and saved the show as the main event.
We're camp partners.
We're forever. Fuck, we're forever.